Maharashtra and Karnataka. Table of contents: 1st, introduction; 2nd, tourism; 3rd, festivals; 4th, cuisine; 5th, dance and music; 6th, economic status; 7th, traditional attire. India is a diverse and vibrant nation with a rich history and cultural heritage. It is the world's largest democracy with over 1.3 billion people. In the following paragraphs, we first delve into India's historical roots and cultural foundations, then look at its economic development and contemporary challenges, and finally consider possible solutions to some of these prevailing challenges. India is located in southern Asia, bordering the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. Neighboring countries include Bangladesh, Bhutan, Burma, China, Nepal, and Pakistan. The country is divided into 28 states and 8 union territories. New Delhi is the capital city of India. India has 22 official languages and is home to several major religions, including Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Islam, Christianity, and Sikhism. Maharashtra. Introduction of Maharashtra. Maharashtra is a state located in the western region of India. It is the third largest state in India by area, covering around 307,713 square kilometers. Maharashtra is the second most populous state in India, where population is 120 million people. The state is bordered by the Arabian Sea in the west, Gujarat in the northwest, Madhya Pradesh in the northeast, Chhattisgarh in the east, Telangana in the southeast, Karnataka in the south, and Goa in the southwest. The western coastline of Maharashtra stretches for around 720 kilometers, and it has many important ports such as Mumbai Port, Jawaharlal Nehru Port, and Mormugao Port. Nowadays it is Maharashtra region but has a rich history dating back to ancient times. This region has been ruled by various dynasties over the centuries, including the Satavahanas, Rashtrakutas, Chalukyas, Yadavas, Bahamanis, and Marathas. Marathas gained their power in the 17th century and played an important role in shaping the history and culture of Maharashtra. The state of Maharashtra was created on the 1st of May 1960 after the linguistic reorganization of the states, with Bombay, now Mumbai, as its capital. Karnataka. Introduction of Karnataka. Karnataka is a state located in the southwestern region of India. It is the sixth largest state in India by area, covering around 191,976 square kilometers. Karnataka is the eighth most populous state in India, with a population of over 66 million people. The state is bordered by Maharashtra in the north, Goa in the northwest, Telangana in the northeast, Andhra Pradesh in the east, Tamil Nadu in the southeast, and Kerala in the southwest. The Western Ghats running through the state and the region is known for its varied geography such as forests, mountains, rivers, and beaches. The history of Karnataka dates back to ancient times and was ruled by various dynasties over the centuries, including the Mauryas, Satavahanas, Chalukyas, Rashtrakutas, Vijayanagara Empire, and the Kingdom of Mysore. The state was originally known as the Kingdom of Mysore until it was renamed Karnataka in 1973 when the states were reorganized linguistically. Karnataka is known for its rich culture influenced by several religions including Hinduism, Jainism, Islam, and Christianity. This state also has several important attractions such as historical monuments, temples, wildlife sanctuaries, and beaches. Maharashtra tourism. Tourism places in Maharashtra. Mumbai. The city of Mumbai, also known as the City of Dreams, is the capital of Maharashtra and a major tourist destination which offering various attractions such as beaches, historical monuments, museums and shopping destinations, Ajanta and Ellora Caves. Located near Aurangabad, the Ajanta and Ellora Caves are UNESCO World Heritage Site with magnificent rock-cut temples and sculptures dating back to the 2nd century BC, Lonavala and Khandala. Located in the Sahyadri Hills, Lonavala and Khandala are popular hill stations known for their scenic beauty, waterfalls and historic forts. Some other tourism places in Maharashtra are Pune, Nashik and Shirdi. Pune. This city is known for its rich history and cultural heritage and is home to many ancient temples, museums and gardens. Nashik. Nashik is an ancient city located on the banks of the Godavari River and is known for its religious significance and scenic beauty. Shirdi. Shirdi is a popular pilgrimage destination for devotees of the famous Saint Sai Baba and attracts millions of people every year. Karnataka tourism. Tourism places in Karnataka. Bengaluru, the capital of Karnataka, also known as the Silicon Valley of India, is a major tourist destination offering various attractions such as parks, museums, shopping areas and historical monuments. Hampi is a UNESCO-specified World Heritage Site and a popular tourist destination known for its magnificent ruins of ancient temples and palaces dating back to the Vijayanagara Empire. Mysore. The city of Mysore is known for its rich cultural heritage and is home to many ancient temples, palaces, and museums. Some other tourism places in Karnataka are Chikmagalur, Gokarna, Coorg. Chikmagalur is a popular hill station known for its coffee plantations, natural beauty and wildlife sanctuaries. Gokarna is a coastal town known for its beautiful beaches and religious importance as it is considered a holy place for Hindus. Coorg, also known as Kodagu, is a popular hill station known for its natural beauty, coffee and spice plantations and wildlife sanctuaries. Maharashtra celebration. Celebration of Ganesh Chaturthi in Maharashtra. Ganesh Chaturthi is a 10-day festival celebrated in Maharashtra and other parts of India that celebrates the birth of Lord Ganesha, the elephant-headed god and also the son of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. The festival usually held in August or September, and it is celebrated with great enthusiasm and fervor across Maharashtra. Several statues of Lord Ganesha are made and installed in homes in public pandals, which are decorated with flowers, lights, and other decorations. Installing the idol of Lord Ganesha involves chanting Vedic hymns and performing various rituals to invoke the divine presence of Ganesha. Devotees pray, sing devotional songs and perform aarti to seek Ganesha's blessings for prosperity, wisdom and success. The festival culminates with the immersion of the idols in water bodies, such as rivers, lakes, or the sea, on the 10th day, which is known as Anant Chaturdashi. Celebration of Janmashtami in Maharashtra. Janmashtami is a Hindu festival celebrated in Maharashtra and other parts of India to mark the birth of Lord Krishna, the 8th avatar of Lord Vishnu. The festival usually held in August or September and celebrated with great fervor and devotion throughout Maharashtra. Temples and homes are decorated with flowers, lights, and other decorations, and devotees fast and offer prayers to Lord Krishna for his blessings. At midnight, which is believed to be the time of Lord Krishna's birth, the idol of the Lord Krishna is bathed with milk and water. After that we dressed him with new clothes and worshipped with great devotion. Devotees also offer sweets, fruits, and other delicacies to Lord Krishna, and sing devotional songs and hymns in his praise. Some communities also organize Raslila, a traditional folk dance representing the life and leelas of Lord Krishna. It is performed by young men and women dressed in colorful costumes. Karnataka celebration. Ugadi celebration in Karnataka. Ugadi is the New Year festival of Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, which marks the beginning of a new lunar year according to the Hindu calendar. The festival usually held in March or April, and it is celebrated with a great joy across Karnataka. The word Ugadi is derived from two Sanskrit words, Yuga meaning era, and Adi meaning beginning, which together means the beginning of a new era. On Ugadi day, people wake up early, bathe and wear new clothes and pray to Lord Brahma, the creator of the universe, seeking his blessings for prosperity and happiness. Traditional Ugadi decorations include mango leaves and flowers, which are used to adorn the entrances of homes and public places. Ugadi's special delicious dishes are prepared, which include the vubela, a mixture of neem leaves and jagyo, which symbolizes hurdles in the life and the need to take them in calmness. Dashehra celebration in Karnataka. Dashehra is a famous Hindu festival celebrated in Karnataka and other parts of India to celebrate the victory of good over evil. This festival usually held in September or October, and it is celebrated with great enthusiasm and grandeur all over Karnataka. The celebration of Dashehra in Karnataka is marked by the Mysuru Dasara, which is a 10-day festival held in the city of Mysore and is considered one of the most significant cultural events in the state. The festival begins with the traditional Dasara procession, a grand procession of decorated elephants, horses and other animals accompanied by musicians, dancers and other performers. The main attraction of the procession is the idol of the goddess Chamundeshwari, who is worshipped as the presiding deity of Mysore. The procession culminates at the Mysore Palace, where the idol of the goddess is placed on a decorated platform and a special puja is performed. Maharashtra foods. Famous foods in Maharashtra. Vada pav. It is a famous and simple snack food consisting of a deep-fried potato dumpling vada served in a bread bun pav with two types of chutney and spices. Misal pav. It is a quite similar dish as vada pav made with sprouted beans, onions, tomatoes, and spices, served with bread bun pav. Poha. It is a popular dish which is takes as a breakfast in Maharashtra. It is made with flattened rice, peanuts, onions, and spices. Some other famous foods in Maharashtra are Modak, Thalipit, Sabudana, Khichdi. Modak. It is a famous sweet, made with rice flour and stuffed with coconut and jaggery filling. This sweet is very important in the Ganesh Chaturthi festival, Thalipit. It is a type of pancake made with a mix of flours, onions, spices, and sometimes vegetables, Sabudana Khichdi. It is a dish made with tapioca pearls, peanuts, and spices, commonly eaten during fasting. Karnataka foods. Famous foods in Karnataka, Bisi Bele Bhat. This is a popular rice dish made from spicy and tangy vegetable stew and served with various side dishes like potato chips, papad and raita, Mysore masala dosa. This is a crispy and spicy crepe made from fermented rice and lentil batter, filled with potato and onion filling and served with chutney and sambar. Idli sambar. It is a steamed rice and lentil cake served with a lentil-based vegetable stew sambar and coconut chutney. Some other famous foods in Karnataka are Madur Vada, Chitrana, Mysore Pak, Madur Vada. It is a crunchy and tasty snack made from a mixture of semolina, rice flour and spices and often served with coconut chutney, Chitrana. It is a flavored rice dish made with lemon, coconut, and spices, and often served as a breakfast or lunch option, Mysore Pak. It is a rich and sweet fudge made with ghee, sugar, and chickpea flour, often served as a dessert or as an accompaniment to coffee or tea. Maharashtra dance. Music and dance in Maharashtra. Lavani. Lavani is a famous folk dance form, originated from Maharashtra. Known for its energetic and sensual movements, it is usually performed to the beat of the dholki drum, Koli. Koli dance is a traditional dance form that originated in the coastal regions of Maharashtra, mainly performed by the Koli community known for their fishing skills. Karnataka dance. Music and dance in Karnataka. Viragase. Viragase is a popular dance form in Karnataka. Jingama performs energy-sapping dance movements very intensely in this vigorous dance based on Hindu mythology. Viragase is performed during the Dasara procession in Mysore and during the Hindu month of Shravana and Kartika Masa. A significant celebration at all important household functions of the Lingayat, Dolu Kunita. In Karnataka, there is a popular folk dance called Dolu Kunita. In Uttara Kannada in northern India, it's primarily done by men and women from the Kuruba community. The group consists of 16 performers, each wearing a drum and playing different rhythms as they dance. The beat, including the drums in the center, is directed by a leader. Slow and fast sounds alternate, creating a unique pattern in the group. Maharashtra economic status. Economic status of Maharashtra. Maharashtra is one of the most economically developed states in India, with a gross domestic product GSDP of over 400 billion in 2020-21, making it the second largest state economy in the country after Uttar Pradesh. The state has a diversified economy with a mix of agriculture, industry, and service sectors. The service sector is the largest contributor to the country's economy, accounting for approximately 60% of the gross domestic product. Maharashtra is home to several important industries such as manufacturing, IT and ITES, finance and banking, and textiles. The state has a strong automotive and engineering industry and is home to the headquarters and production facilities of several major automakers. The state is also a major agricultural producer, with a large share of the country's sugarcane, cotton, and soybean production. Maharashtra is the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in India. The capital city of Mumbai is the financial and commercial hub of the country and is home to several major financial institutions, stock exchanges, and multinational corporations. The highest taxpayers of India lived in Mumbai, which is the capital of Maharashtra, and Mumbai is the origin of Bollywood in India. Karnataka economic status. Economic status of Karnataka. Karnataka is one of the most economically developed states in India, with a gross domestic product GSDP of over 250 billion in 2020-21, making it the fourth largest state economy in the country. The state has a diversified economy with a mix of agriculture, industry, and service sectors. The service sector is the largest contributor to this country's economy, accounting for approximately 55% of the gross domestic product. Karnataka is home to several key industries such as software and IT services, biotechnology, aerospace, and engineering. The country is a major producer of iron and steel, heavy machinery, and machine tools. The country is also a major agricultural producer, accounting for a large proportion of the country's coffee, sugarcane, and silk production. Karnataka is the largest producer of coffee in India. The capital city of Bengaluru is the IT and startup capital of India and is home to several major IT companies, startups, and multinational corporations. Economic indicator, GDP in 2023. Maharashtra $430 billion and Karnataka $200 billion. Contribution to India's GDP. Maharashtra 13.88% and Karnataka 7.87%. Major industries. In Maharashtra, automobile, textiles, pharmaceuticals, and in Karnataka, it, biotechnology, aerospace. Poverty rate in Maharashtra is 17.35% and in Karnataka is 20.91%. Human Development Index HDI. In Maharashtra is 0.683 and in Karnataka is 0.682. Maharashtra traditional attire. Traditional attire of Maharashtra. Nuwari sari, kasta sari, dhoti and feta. Nuwari sari is a 9-yard long sari that is draped in a certain way to create a trouser-like look. It is usually worn with a short sleeve blouse or choli. The Nuwari sari is wrapped around the waist and the legs are separated, making it easy to move. Rural areas women usually use it both for daily use and celebration. The kasta sari is a 6-yard long sari that is draped in a unique way to form a punt-like appearance. It is popular to use in bridal attire. The dhoti is a rectangular piece of cloth that is draped around the waist and legs. It is usually made of cotton or silk and is worn with a short-sleeved shirt or a kurta. Feta is made of cotton or silk and is usually tied in a unique style. These attires usually wear in wedding, religious ceremonies and other important events. Karnataka traditional attire. Traditional attire of Karnataka. The traditional men's wear of Karnataka is kurta and lungi. Kurta is a long shirt that reaches to the knees. It is paired with lungi or dhoti, which are loose pants wrapped around the legs and tied around the waist. Mundu vesti is a traditional male attire in Karnataka consisting of a dhoti and a shawl. The dhoti is wrapped around the waist and legs, while the shawl is draped over the shoulder. It is often used during weddings and religious ceremonies. Mysore silk sari is a traditional sari made of pure silk, famous for its rich texture and vibrant colors. It is the most popular traditional dress of Karnataka women worn during weddings, festivals and other special occasions. Ilkal sari is a traditional sari from the Ilkal region of Karnataka. Made of cotton and silk, it is known for its unique border design and bold colors. Kasuti sari is also a traditional sari from northern Karnataka. It is made of cotton and is embroidered with intricate designs using silk thread. Thank you.